Have you filed a petition or application with USCIS and you have no idea where it stands and you cannot find anybody to help you, especially when you call that wonderful number USCIS gives us? Well, this video, I'm going to take you through step by step of exactly how you can find out what status the application is by yourself without any help from anybody. It's as easy as using your cell phone. Let's do it. Hi, and thank you for joining me to talk immigration. My name is Andrea Shev, and I am the managing attorney at Shev Law Group in Los Angeles, California. I've been doing immigration for almost 20 years now, and I've put together a ton of videos for you so you get clear, concise, and easy to understand information on all types of immigration topics. Now, make sure you don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and don't forget to also hit that notification bell, that bell right down there, so you don't miss out on any future videos. And also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Facebook because I'm there all the time posting immigration topics and also just information about me. Get to know me a little bit better. So let's get into this topic of how to check your status online all by yourself without having to deal with anybody else. Okay, so what do we do and how do we check our case status? Well, it's very simple, but there's important things that you must know as you go through the steps to make sure that you get the correct information that you're looking for. So the first thing you want to do is get a hold of a few types of things. You want to be on your computer or on your cell phone, first of all, and you want to have in front of you your receipt that you received from USCIS in the mail when you filed your application. It's called an I-797. It's a form, and it looks like this. And on this form, you'll notice in the top left-hand corner, there's going to be a receipt number. It starts sometimes with a WAC, sometimes it starts with an EAC, but there's a receipt number in the top left-hand corner of that receipt. So you're gonna have to get that also in front of you, okay? So let's begin. What do we do first? First, we go to uscis.gov and we hit check case status, right here. You check case status. Second, once you get there and you click check case status, it's going to take you to a page that asks for that receipt number that is in the top left-hand corner of your receipt notice. So go and right now, look at your receipt right now and check the top left-hand corner and input that into that space that says receipt number. Click enter and here we go. Here we are at the page where it gives us the actual status of your case right now. So here we are and we have the information. What are you going to do with that information? Well, that information on there is going to give you the most up-to-date information about your particular case and what's going on now. Now, what are the things to look for? If it just says it's pending, it's pending. Take a watch, look at it as often as you want to make sure when it changes. The key ones that you really want to take a notice of is when they've sent you something in the mail or if they sent you information that you maybe didn't get yet. So it's a good idea to check it regularly because sometimes they'll send out, let's say, a request for evidence for more information and you never got it in the mail. Well, if you're checking your status, you'll know when they sent it and then you'll know, wow, it's been like 3 weeks and I haven't even gotten it yet. So then you should really contact USCIS. Also, sometimes let's say you're doing an immigrant interview and you're married to a US citizen and you go to your interview and they say, we'll let you know. You know, when you end the interview, they don't give you a yes or no or an approved. They say, we'll let you know. That's very common these days. So you're sitting there at home going like, okay, well, when am I gonna know? Well, if you check online, you will likely see the approved notice saying that your case has been approved and what date and what the next steps are before you get something in the mail, which is really nice, right? So you don't have to sit there waiting for 3 weeks or 4 weeks for an actual approval notice in the mail. You'll know right away that you've been approved online. The other thing that's really critical is when they mail you, for example, an employment authorization card or they mail you your permanent resident card or your conditional permanent resident card, they will let you know when the card is in production online. They'll let you know when the card has been mailed. And more importantly than all of that, they will give you a tracking number once the card has been shipped. And they will show you on their tracking number if you check what zip code it's going to. So you'll know exactly, you'll be able to track where that card is and when you should have received it, so you know exactly what's going on. Now, of course, it's not perfect, and of course, a lot of times it says in the same status for a very long time because the processing times are so long, but it gives you some control in this uncontrollable world we're living in of what is going on with the case that you filed. Sometimes your case is going to be pending for a year, sometimes even longer, sometimes even shorter. But at least you can go online at any time, 24/7, on your cell phone, on your computer, wherever you want, and you can get exactly what's going on with your case without having to sit on hold for how long, who knows how long these days, to try to get to a human that's going to tell you exactly the same information that is on that website. So I hope all of you found that really helpful and you go online right now, this minute, and check the status of your case, and fingers crossed you have some good news when you actually get in there. Thank you all for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe so you can watch all our videos, and don't forget to hit that notification bell so you're notified every single time a new video comes out. And lastly, don't forget to also follow me on social media, Instagram and Facebook. I'm there all the time posting things a lot faster than I do on YouTube. Have a wonderful morning, afternoon, evening, wherever you are in the world, and thank you for watching, and stay safe out there.